Welcome back, students. Let's talk about what we had discussed yesterday. Let's have a quick recall of that. The very first thing that we discussed was the various types of numbers. The very first thing that we discussed was natural numbers. What were natural numbers? Just recall it. It were the counting numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. Then we discussed whole numbers. What were whole numbers? Whole numbers were including all the natural numbers along with 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on. Then it was integers. Integers means all the whole numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on, plus negatives of the natural numbers. Then rational numbers. Rational numbers, those can be written in the form of p by q, like 3 by 5. 7 by 8 of the type. Then irrational numbers. Irrational numbers which cannot be written in the form of p by q, like root 23, root 7, pi, etc. Right? And then we classified that all these first four types are collectively known as rationals. And this is separate, which is irrational. We have already talked about. Then there is one new thing, that all of these numbers, all of these means rationals plus irrationals, these are collectively called real numbers. So the numbers you know till date, the numbers you know by today, you are clear with the rational numbers till your lower classes. Now in 9th you have learnt one more number, that is irrational number. Iske bina aapko aur koi number nahi pata hai. To jo bhi numbers aapko pata hai, wo sare kis category mein aayenge? Real numbers mein. There is one another type of numbers, that is imaginary numbers, but you don't know anything about imaginary numbers. So jo bhi aapke mind mein question number aata hai, jo bhi aap soch sakte ho, 1 lakh, 2 crores, 7.9, 3.878787, any number which you can think about is a real number only. Clear? Now let's talk about finding the rationals or irrational numbers between given numbers. Question is, find 6 rational numbers between given 2 numbers 3 and 4. Aapko 3 and 4 ke beech mein koi bhi 6 rational numbers find out karne. To rational numbers wahi jo something upon p by q ki form mein likh sakte hain. To you have to find, agar hum counting ki baat karein, agar aapko kaha jaye find any 3 rational numbers between 3 and 5, to 3 and 5 ke beech mein ek integer aata hai, that is 4. Now you are given with 3 and 4, iske beech mein integer to koi bhi nahi aayega, only rational numbers will occur and irrational numbers will occur. So we will, the question is find the rational numbers. So the very simple method to find the rational numbers between any 2 given numbers is, change this number, not actually change this number, modify it and write it in some other form. Agar mere paas ek number 3 hai and dusra hai 4, I am writing 4 over here and 3 over here. Now I know that I can write this 3 as 3 multiply by 10 and divide by 10, so that it will become 30 upon 10. Is it? Because 30 upon 10 after simplification ye banega to 3 hi. Same, I can write 4 as 4 multiply by 10 and divide by 10, that is 40 upon 10. Now why to multiply and divide by 10? Because 10 se 10 ka table sabko aata hai, 10 se calculation bahut easy hoti hai. Otherwise it is up to you. The other method is, in dono numbers ko plus kariye, 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 se upar multiply kariye, 7 se niche kariye. But no hard and fast rules, so you can go with 10 also. So this is 30 by 10 and 40 by 10. Now you can very easily find 6 numbers between 30 and 40. So 6 numbers, 6 rational numbers, you have to write it complete, 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4 are 3 is my 30 by 10 and 4 is my 40 by 10. So 30 by 10 and 40 by 10 ke beech mein kaun se main rational numbers likh sakti hu? 31 by 10, 32 by 10, 33 by 10, 34 by 10, 35 by 10, 36 by 10, any 6 rational numbers you can pick from here and then write. Was it visible? Clear? Now let's talk about the next question. Question is, find 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Now we have to find 5 rational numbers, and the question that is given to you is in fractions. So here I will write 3 by 5 and here I will write 4 upon 5. Now again I told you, you can multiply by 10. So if I will multiply both the numerator and denominator by 10, this will become 30 by 50. And if I'll multiply over here also, so this will become 40 by 50. Just keep one thing in mind, that your denominators should be same. Here my denominator is 50 and here also 50. In previous question, denominators were 10, so no problem. But if your denominators are not same, then you know how to make the denominators same first from your lower classes. Make the denominators same and then proceed further. Now, can you find any 5 rational numbers between 30 by 50 and 40 by 50? Obviously, yes. So, 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5 are... What are these? 30 by 50 and 40 by 50 से कोई भी बीच वाले 5 उठा लीजिए. 31 by 50, 32 by 50, 33 by 50, 34 by 50, 35 by 50. Either you can write 39 by 50 also, because it also occur between 30 and 40. No, there is no such compulsion that you have to write the consecutive numbers only. Am I clear how many I have written? I have written 6, but the question was to write 5 only, so you can write any 5. Clear? This was the method to find rational numbers, any 5, any 6 rational numbers between given 2 numbers. Now we will find irrational numbers between any given numbers. Find 3 irrational numbers between 5 by 7 and 9 by 11. Now, as I told you yesterday also, there are infinitely many irrational numbers. Again, now we are finding irrational. Keep this thing in mind. We are finding irrational numbers. So, what is the way to solve it? We are given with the first number 5 by 7. What we will do, we will divide this number 5 by 7. And if you will solve it, I have done it already. If you will solve it, you will get 0.714285. Again, 714285, 7142. It will never terminate. And it will keep on repeating. So, I will put a bar over here. Because these 6 numbers are getting repeated, so it is 5 by 7 is equals to 0.71485 pa. Next number was 9 by 11. So 9 by 11, if you will divide 9 with 11, then you will get 0.818181, like this. So 0.81 bar. Clear? Now, you know what is 5 by 7 and what is 9 by 11. Aapko in do ke beech mein irrational numbers find out karne the. Now look for these decimal expressions. You can find, you can write any irrational numbers. Irrational numbers between 5 by 7 and 9 by 11 are. What are these irrational numbers? To aap koi bhi likh sakte ho. Irrational numbers की condition क्या होती है कि वो terminate नहीं होता. अगर आप उसका decimal expansion निकालोगे, as I told you yesterday also, कि जैसे हमारा pi है, वो irrational क्यों है? कि अगर उसका divide करोगे तो वो terminate नहीं होगा, वो आगे आगे चलता जाएगा, खत्म नहीं होगा. जैसे आपने 5 को इसमें आप divide करके check करोगे, then you will find that it will also not terminate, but ये repeat होना शुरू हो जाएगा. जैसे 714285 आ गया, फिर से 714285, ये repeat होता जाएगा. पर irrational के केस में it will neither repeat nor terminate. So आप इसके बीच में से ऐसे से कोई भी number लिख सकते हो. The numbers will be, can be, कोई भी pick कर लो आप. 0. ये 71 से start हो रहा था, हम लिख देते हैं 7 2 3 5 7 9 3 5 8 7 2 6. मैं repeat भी नहीं कर रही हूँ, right? Repeat भी नहीं कर रही हूँ, and it is also not terminating, so I am putting like this. Other number you can write as 0.746739265176. 7 like this. मेरे numbers repeat नहीं हो रहे हैं. I'm not talking about this कि मेरा 3 यहाँ पे है तो दोबारा 3 नहीं आएगा. I'm talking about the sequence. If it was 7 1 4 2 8 5, उसके बाद फिर अगर 7 आएगा, then उसके बाद 1 आएगा, 4 2 8 5, उसके बाद फिर 7 1 4 2 8 5 आएगा. Means जैसे हमारा बार आता है लोअर क्लासेस में, यू हैव डन दिस ऑलरेडी. सो टू नंबर्स आई फाउंड, यू कैन राइट थर्ड नंबर बाय योर ओन. नाउ नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट काइंड ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन द फॉलोइंग विल हैव. आपको नीचे क्वेश्चंस दिए हैं, आपको चेक करना है कि इफ यू विल डिवाइड इट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन विल इट हैव. काइंड्स ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन की अगर आप बात करते हो, then what are the kinds of decimal expansion? The very first type is terminating. कि अगर आप divide करोगे तो आपका कुछ ना कुछ result आके वो terminate कर जाएगा. जैसे कि आप 10 से divide करोगे, 10 को divide करोगे 2 से, 2 5s are 10 and remainder is 0. Remainder 0 आ गया, so it is done. Means ये terminate कर गया, यहीं तक आएगा ना आपका answer. Second, this is first type. Then comes to the second type. Second type is repeating plus non-terminating. That your decimal expansion is not terminating but it is repeating. As we have done in our previous question, 9 by 11, if you will divide 9 with 11, it will give you 0.8181 up to so on. So, iska matlab kya hai? Ye terminate to nahi ho raha, khatam nahi ho raha, but it is repeating. So, it is repeating plus non-terminating. Sometimes, this repeating is also termed as recurring. Reoccurring means, jo bar bar occur kar. The third type can be, first is terminating, then non-terminating plus recurring, then non-terminating plus non-recurring. ना तो वो terminate हो रहा है, ना वो repeat हो रहा है, जैसे कि हमने ऊपर करा. तो ये जो आपकी first two वाली types हैं, terminating वाली plus repeating non-terminating वाली, these two expansions, ये अगर आपको कहीं पे मिल रही है, if you are solving a question and you are getting something of this type, तो it means it will be your rational number. And if it is coming out to be non-terminating plus non-recurring, then it belongs to irrational numbers. Clear? Now let's move to the question. The question is 36/100. 36/100. So if you will divide 36 with 100, what you will get? Otherwise you know, because denominator has 2 zeros, so it will be 0.36, but still I want to show you 0 point and then it will become 360. 0, 100, 3s are 300, remainder is 660, decimal already there, so it will be 600, 3, 6s are 600, so it is giving you 0.36. Now the question was what kind of decimal expansion does it have? So it is terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal expansion. Done. Second question. Second part is if I'll say it is 1 by 11. Let's try 1 by 11. So divide 1 by 11. Your numerator will be divided by the denominator. 11 is obviously bigger number, so it will be 0.0. Then again put a decimal 0. Not a decimal, 0. Then it is 100. 11 9s are 99. 1. Decimal is already there, 0. But it is again not getting divided. So is it clear to you that it will be 090909 up to so on? ये टर्मिनेट नहीं होगा, सो इट विल बी 09 बार. सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन इज इट? इट इज नॉट टर्मिनेटिंग, टर्मिनेट तो नहीं होगा, ये चलता जाएगा. नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग प्लस रिपीटिंग. रिपीटिंग इफ यू वांट टू राइट रिपीटिंग, यू कैन राइट रिपीटिंग ऑल्सो. इफ यू वांट टू राइट रिकरिंग, देन यू कैन राइट रिकरिंग ऑल्सो. non-terminated plus recurring. Is it okay? So you have to further try the questions I will give you. You have to try by your own. You can try 4 and 1 by 8. First of all, solve this mixed fraction. 8 fours are 32 plus 1 35. It is 35 by 8. Divide it and then you will get the answer. Further, 1 by 7. Okay, that is it. Baki aap kar lena kuch se. Ye questions aap karke dekh lena ek baar. Then, one more thing I want to talk about. Okay, before, let me solve this so that the concept will be clear to you. 35 divided by 8. You know 8 fours are 32. 3 will be the remainder. Put a decimal, then 0. Then 8 fours are 32, 8 fives are 40. So it is, 8 threes are 24. 6 decimal is already there, 0. 8 sevens are 56. 4 decimal is already there, 0. 8 fives are 40. So this is done. Now the decimal expansion is of, ye to terminate ho gaya. So it is terminating because remainder 0 aa gaya. Now, did you notice one thing? Jis case mein hamara denominator 0 aaya hai. Remainder 0 aaya. Mean terminating wala jo hamara expansion aaya hai. Do hi cases mein aaya. Look at the denominators of these questions. Here denominator is 100. Yahan pe hamara terminating aaya tha, denominator is 100. So if you will find the factors of 100, 100 is 50 into 2. And 50 is 25 into 2 and 25 is 5 into 5 into 2 into 2. So, aapke 100 ke factors yehi banenge 5 into 5 into 2 into 2. Aur agar aap yahan ki baat karo, here also your remainder was 0 means your decimal expansion was terminating. So, agar aap 8 ke factors ki baat karo, then it will be 2 into 2 into 2. So what will this signify? This tells us that we will get terminating decimal expansion only. Okay, you have to write it also. So I will write separately. When will you get a terminating decimal expansion? The rule is denominator should be of the form 2 raised to power something into 5 raised to power something. I have written 2 raised to power m into 5 raised to power n, where this m and n both can be any of the natural or any of the whole number, because it can be 0 also. As we had seen that when denominator was 8, say my question is 7 by 8. Here denominator is 8. So denominator ke factors kya ban rahe hain? 2 into 2 into 2 means 7 upon 2 cube. Here I am getting the factors of denominator as 2 raised to power something. But there is nothing in the power of no factor is of the form 5 raised to power something. So we can assume it as 5 raised to power 0, because you have done anything raised to power 0 is 1. So 5 raised to power 0 means 1. Clear? So terminating decimal expansion ke liye, you have to note it down in your fair copies that terminating decimal expansion will only be if the denominator is having the factors as 2 and 5 only. If you are getting any other factor in the denominator other than 2 and 5, then it will obviously be non-terminating. Now let's do a practical question. We know that how to represent a number on a number line. Hame pata hai ki 2 kahan pe hota hai, 5 kahan pe hota hai. You know what is a number line? Basically a single line which is representing a all the numbers that you know. If a number line consists of all the numbers, all the real numbers that you know, then it obviously will contain irrational numbers also. plotting irrational numbers on number line. Now we will plot the irrational number on number line. It was not visible, sorry. So अगर आप रैशनल नंबर्स दिखा सकते हो नंबर लाइन पे तो ऑब्वियसली इरैशनल नंबर्स भी होंगे. फॉर दैट ड्रॉ अ नंबर लाइन फर्स्ट. अच्छा, बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द दिस प्लॉटिंग ऑफ इरैशनल नंबर आई वांट टू रिकॉल यू द पाइथागोरस थ्योरम. डू यू रिमेम्बर व्हाट इज पाइथागोरस थ्योरम? पाइथागोरस थ्योरम सेज दैट इन अ राइट एंगल्ड ट्राइंगल, if this is my right angle triangle, this will be my hypotenuse, perpendicular and base, right? Pythagoras theorem says that hypotenuse square is equals to perpendicular square plus base square. How now we know that the number of the form, like I am giving you a number root 2. So root 2 will be irrational number. What about root 5? Root 5 will also be an irrational number. What about root 25? Root 25, is it irrational or rational? It is rational. Why rational? Because root 25 is equals to 5 and 5 is can be written in the form of 5 upon 1. So it is rational. Clear? Now, if you want to represent root 2 on number line, तो आपको क्या करना है? You have to work on this Pythagoras theorem. आपको ऐसे दो numbers ढूंढने हैं जिनके squares को plus करके आपके पास 2 आ जाए. If you want to plot root 2, आपको ऐसे दो numbers ढूंढने हैं number line, ऐसे दो numbers ढूंढने हैं जिनके squares को plus करके 2 आ जाए. तो 2 यहाँ पे मैं किसी का square लिखूंगी plus यहाँ पे किसी का square लिखूंगी. यहाँ पे क्या fill करूंगी? मेरे पास answer 2 आ जाए. Obviously, I will fill 1. Why 1? Because 1 square is 1. 1 square is 1. So, which will give me 2. Clear? If I want to plot 5 on number line, what will I do? I will write something square plus something square equals to 5. Kin do ke squares go plus karne pe 5 aa jayega mere paas. If I will write 1 over here. 1 square is 1. Ab 1 mein kitna plus karenge 5 aa jaye? 4. Par 4 kiska square hota hai? 2 ka. तो 5 is equals to 1 plus 4, 5 is equals to 5 हो गया. मेरा पर्पस था कि मुझे ये दो नंबर्स मिल जाएं, किन दो का स्क्वायर करूं मैं कि मेरे पास 5 आ जाए. इफ आई वांट टू प्लॉट रूट 5 ऑन नंबर लाइन. अब ये रूट की यहां पे रूट क्यों नहीं है? क्योंकि यहां पे क्या होता है क्वेश्चन? हाइपोटेन्यूज स्क्वायर होता है. तो ये 5 किसका स्क्वायर होगा? ऑब्वियसली रूट 5 का स्क्वायर होगा. तो ये मुझे रूट 5 मिल जाएगा. If I want to plot root 2 on number line, तो मुझे कौन से दो numbers चाहिए होंगे? 1 and 1. Basic idea is clear to you. Now let's plot. First of all, draw a number line. Draw a number line. To show you bigger, I will not consider this 1 centimeter as my one unit. तो मैं यहाँ पे gap ले लेती हूँ. Just a minute. ये. If it is visible to you, this is my 2.5. So I will consider it as my 1. Then after 2.5, 2.5 plus 2.5 is 5. 5 plus 2.5 is 7.5. 7.5 plus 5 is, 2.5 is 10. Done. Now what you have to do, this is my number line. Say this is my 0. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, I know that I am plotting root 5 on number line. I know that root 5 ko hum kaise likh sakte hain? Under root of 1 square plus 2 square. Ye humne yahan pe numbers find out kare the na, 1 and 2. To usi ke basis pe ek side mein 1 dhoondungi, ek side mein 2 dhoondungi. If I am finding 2 over here. ये मेरा 2 है. From here I will construct an angle of 90 degree, because I cannot use a compass over here, and also we know that 90 degree is a straight, 90 degree angle is easy to draw without even compass. So I will draw with just simply with a scale, a line over here. otherwise you have to draw it with your compass or directly with protractor. Now I chosen one unit as 2.5 centimeters, so here also I will consider 2.5 centimeter as my one unit. This is and here it is clear. पर इस तरफ मुझे 2 लेना था एंड इस तरफ कितना लेना है 1. इट इज अप टू यू. आप यहां से 1 लेके यहां इधर ऊपर 2 ले सकते हो. मैंने इधर 2 लेके यहां पे 1 ले लिया. सो दिस इज माय नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. नाउ व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू ज्वाइन दीज. क्लियर. नाउ take a compass, open it up to the, mark it as O A and this is B. Take a compass, open it up to the radius OB and then draw an arc like this. वो point जहां पे वो arc आपकी x ये number line को touch करेगी वो आपका क्या होगा, that will represent root 5. I will show you, wait. Now open your compass up to this radius OB. ये hypotenuse I told you कि अगर आपका ये 2 है and ये 1 है तो automatically this will be your root 5. यही करा था हमने यहां से. तो ये root 5 है, आप root 5 जितना यहां से open कर लीजिए अपनी compass को और फिर यहां पे जहां पे भी वो intersect करेगा that point will be your root 5. So I will say this is my, ये जो आँख है आपने pencil से ही लगी रहने देनी है, इसको नहीं highlight करना with pen. So this is my root 5. If it is still not clear to you, I will discuss one more example. Now we will plot root 2 on number line. To plot root 2, first of all, think of two numbers whose sum of whose squares can give you 2. ऐसे कोई भी दो नंबर सोचो जिनके स्क्वेयर्स को आप प्लस करो और आपके पास 2 आ जाए. Obviously, 1 square plus 1 square आपको 2 देगा, right? तो आपने क्या करना है? नंबर लाइन ड्रॉ करनी है सबसे पहले. तो नंबर लाइन पे बेसिकली हम इक्वल गैपिंग के साथ करते हैं ना, आपको पता है. तो वो इक्वल गैपिंग अगर मैं यहां से 1 1 सेंटीमीटर वाली लूं तो वो बहुत छोटी हो जाएगी, इट विल नॉट बी विजिबल टू यू. एंड इट इज परफेक्टली फाइन इफ यू आर टेकिंग 2 सेंटीमीटर 3 सेंटीमीटर इन योर नोटबुक्स आल्सो, नो प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज माय नंबर लाइन, नॉट जीरो, से दिस इज माय नंबर लाइन. नाउ आई नो दैट मुझे जो नंबर, दो नंबर्स चाहिए वो कौन कौन से है, 1 1. तो मुझे 1 सेंटीमीटर इधर से लेना है और 1 सेंटीमीटर मतलब ये मेरा बेस भी 1 सेंटीमीटर होगा एंड परपेंडिकुलर भी 1 सेंटीमीटर होगा. देन ऑटोमेटिकली आई विल गेट माई हाइपोटेन्यूज एज रूट 2. सो इफ आई एम टेकिंग, चलिए आपको 2.5 में अगर एरर प्रॉब्लम आ रही है तो मैं 3 सेंटीमीटर का ले लूं अपना 1 यूनिट. And then next will be at 6 centimeter, next will be at 9 centimeter. Clear? पर अब मुझे यहां से चलना था, अगर ये मेरा 0 है, if I have to start from here, or you can consider your 0 here also, because negatives में भी तो numbers चलते हैं. चलो वो भी दिखा देते हैं आपको, number line अच्छे से दिखेगा. This is my -1, this is 0, 1, 2 up to so on. This is my number line. अब मैंने यहां से चलना है 1 यूनिट इस तरफ, क्योंकि मेरा बेस कितना है 1 सेंटीमीटर. सो दैट इज मैं यहां आ गई. अब परपेंडिकुलर के लिए तो यहां पे 90 डिग्री का एंगल होना चाहिए, तो वो आप एंगल कंस्ट्रक्ट कर लीजिए. अब मैं आपको करके दिखा रही हूं. ओपन योर कंपास अप टू एनी रेडियस एंड देन ड्रॉ अ सेमी सर्कल लाइक दिस, देन ओपन अ लिटिल मोर एंड देन do like this. Nothing to teach you because this you have already done in your lower classes, how to construct an angle of 90 degree. So ye banega mera 90 degree, done. So this is my 90 degree, but I have chosen the scale as 3 centimeter to be the 1 unit. To yahan pe bhi mera 3 centimeter ke baad hi 1 unit complete hoga. To ye raha 3, तो हेयर इट विल बी माय 1 यूनिट. तो ये तो मेरा बेस हो गया 1 यूनिट.
और ये मेरा परपेंडिकुलर हो गया 1 यूनिट. नाउ आई विल ज्वाइन दिस 1 विद 1. अब ये जो बनेगा ये ऑटोमेटिकली √2 होगा, बिकॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू पाइथागोरस थ्योरम दिस स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू दिस स्क्वायर प्लस दिस स्क्वायर. √2 स्क्वायर विल बी 2, 1 स्क्वायर प्लस 1 स्क्वायर विल बी 2. तो ये ठीक है. अब हमें, मुझे तो ये √2 यहां नहीं दिखाना था, आई हैव टू शो इट ऑन द नंबर लाइन. तो वॉट आई विल डू, आई विल पिक अप माई कंपस एंड ओपन इट अप टू दिस रेडियस एंड देन आई विल कट माई नंबर लाइन जहां पे भी वो कटेगा विद दिस रेडियस. इज इट विजिबल? यहां तक मैंने ओपन करा और इसको यहां से कट कर दिया. देन दिस पॉइंट, दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग √2. क्लियर? नो स्टेप्स ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन टू बी रिटन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. सिंपली यू हैव टू ड्रॉ, यू हैव टू ड्रॉ बोथ √2 एंड √5 ऑल्सो. √2 ऑल्दो इट इज नॉट इन योर नोटबुक्स इन योर NCERTs, बट स्टिल यू हैव टू ड्रॉ टू मेक इट, टू मेक द कंसेप्ट मोर क्लियर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, इफ यू आर गिवन दैट 1/7 इज इक्वल्स टू दिस 0.142857 बार, then what will be the value of 2/7 and you have to do this by without actually doing the division. बिना डिवाइड करे आप कैसे बता सकते हो कि इसकी वैल्यू 2/7 की वैल्यू क्या आएगी? यू नो दैट 2/7 इज 2 × 1/7, सो इट मीन्स 2 × जो आपके पास 1/7 की वैल्यू थी, मल्टीप्लाई इट, मल्टीप्लाई दिस वैल्यू बाय 2, सो यू विल गेट 0.428, 14 × 28, 56, 57, 11, 4. So this will be your answer. जहां पे आपका बार स्टार्ट हो रहा था बार यहां पे भी. Similarly for finding the value of 3/7, simply multiply your value of 1/7 with 3. What was the value of 1/7? 0.142857. Multiply this value with 3. इट जो भी आपका आंसर आएगा उस पे पीछे जहां पे भी बार था वहां पे बार डाल. क्लियर? आगे अगर 4/7, 5/7 जो भी पूछा है वो आप करिएगा. नाउ लेट्स क्विकली टॉक अबाउट दीज 3 क्वेश्चंस, देन वी विल एंड विद दिस लेक्चर. एवरी इरेशनल नंबर इज रियल. जो भी इरेशनल नंबर्स हैं वो सारे रियल हैं. I told you in the beginning of the lecture कि जितने भी numbers आप जानते हो आप reals ही जानते हो, real के बिना आपको कुछ नहीं पता. So every irrational number is real, obviously yes. अगर कभी भी आपको पूछा जाए कि is it real, तो real के केस में तो no आएगा ही नहीं, क्योंकि real के बिना आपको कोई भी number अभी तक नहीं पता है. The number other than reals that you are going to learn, that you will learn in your 11th and 12th and or higher classes. 11th से पहले आपको रियल के बारे में कुछ नहीं पता होगा. सो अगर क्वेश्चन है कि इज इट रियल, तो ऑब्वियसली यस, बिकॉज हमने करा था कि जो भी नंबर्स हमने डिस्कस करे हैं वो सारे रियल्स की कैटेगरी में ही आएंगे. देन सेकेंड इज, एवरी पॉइंट ऑन नंबर लाइन इज ऑफ द फॉर्म √m. अभी हमने रूट दिखाया है ना नंबर लाइन पे, √2, √5 भी दिखाया. दे आर सेइंग कि नंबर लाइन पे जो भी नंबर्स आते हैं वो रूट की फॉर्म में ही आते हैं. इज इट? अब देखो कोई नंबर तो ऐसा भी होगा जिसको हम रूट की फॉर्म में नहीं लिख सकते. सारे ही थोड़ी पॉसिबल है कि रूट की फॉर्म में आए. जैसे नाउ दे आर सेइंग रूट ऑफ m, और m कोई भी नेचुरल नंबर है, और कभी भी हम किसी भी नेगेटिव नंबर का रूट डिफाइन नहीं कर सकते जब तक आप 10th में हो. अगर -3 आ जाए, ठीक है, ओके okay, चलो इन्होंने तो यहां पे बोला ही आपको सिर्फ नेचुरल नंबर्स के लिए है, बट दिस इज स्टिल नॉट पॉसिबल, बिकॉज आप सारे नंबर्स को, आपने √2 को रिप्रेजेंट कर दिया नंबर लाइन पे, √3 को कर दिया, तो इसके बीच में भी तो और बहुत सारे नंबर्स है, उसको किसका रूट लिखोगे? आई टोल्ड यू कि कोई भी दो गिवन नंबर्स के बीच में इनफाइनाइटली मेनी इरेशनल नंबर्स आ जाएंगे. आपने √2 भी प्लॉट कर दिया नंबर लाइन पे, √3 भी कर दिया, पर इसके बीच वाले नंबर्स को किसका रूट बोलोगे? क्योंकि 2 से बड़ा जो है 3 वो हमने रिप्रेजेंट कर दिया, 3 से छोटा जो है 2 वो भी रिप्रेजेंट कर दिया, सो इसका आंसर विल बी फॉल्स. फर्स्ट वन वॉज ट्रू. एवरी रियल नंबर इज इरेशनल. अभी हमने कहा है कि जितने भी इरेशनल नंबर्स हैं वो रियल हैं. यस yes. पर क्या सारे रियल नंबर्स इरेशनल होंगे? नो, बिकॉज रियल नंबर्स तो नेचुरल भी हो सकते हैं, होल भी हो सकते हैं, इंटीजर्स भी हो सकते हैं, रैशनल्स भी हो सकते हैं. सो इट इज अगेन फॉल्स. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आई टॉट यू टुडे. गुड लक एंड कंप्लीट दिस. थैंक यू.